In this Q&A video, we're going to answer the question, can I use flexible metal conduit as a circuit protective conductor? Now, this question relates to the video that Gary and Gordon produced on ATCOR's excellent slit flexible conduit, and it really is an excellent product and video, so check it out if you haven't already watched it. Now, the conduit in that video is made out of plastic, and so that enables us to answer this question with a very firm no. It will not be suitable for use as a CPC. However, what if we replaced that conduit with a metallic flexible conduit? Would that be acceptable as a CPC? Well, BS7671 tells us some things that we can use as a circuit protective conductor in regulation 543.2.1. Does it mention it there? A protective conductor may consist of one or more of the following. 1. A single core cable. 2. A conductor in a cable. 3. An insulated or bare conductor in a common enclosure with insulated live conductors. 4. A fixed bare or insulated conductor. 5. A metal covering, for example, the sheath, screen or armoring of a cable. 6. A metal conduit, metallic cable management system or other enclosure or electrically continuous support system for conductors. And 7. An extraneous conductive part complying with regulation 543.2.6. So no specific mention of a flexible metallic conduit there, but it does mention metal conduit and a metallic cable management system. So maybe that covers it. We'll move on a couple of regs and we find 543.2.3, which states that a gas pipe, an oil pipe, flexible or pliable conduit, support wires or other flexible metallic parts or constructional parts subject to mechanical stress in normal service shall not be selected as a protective conductor. So that's fairly conclusive then. But why do the regs state this? After all, it's a piece of metal going from A to B, so what's the problem? Well, the problem is down to the nature and structure of flexible conduit itself. Metallic conduit is actually just a big long spiral of metal that kind of interlocks with itself. But that interlocking is designed to move against itself, which means that you can't rely on each section making a good electrical connection with the next one. Apart from a brush in a motor, there's not many places where we rely on an unfixed electrical connection, especially not for a safety connection. And in the event of an earth fault, we couldn't rely on the electrical connections made from one loop to the other to hold that fault current. So if we can't rely on the connections between each section of the spiral, that means that the length of the CPC would potentially be as long as the spiral, uncoiled, which is going to be really long, have a relatively small cross-sectional area, a relatively high resistivity, and therefore a high resistance. Not ideal for a safety conductor. So if this type of conduit is going to be used to connect a machine, then a separate conductor must be run in to act as a circuit protective conductor inside the conduit. But as always, we want to hear from you, so please leave your thoughts and questions in the comments below. All that remains in this video is to say, thank you very much for watching.